Hello guys, welcome back to Let's Play Chaos Head. Last time we were told by Remy, we are basically non-existent. But we do exist. For some reason. Someone imagined us being real, so we are real. Turns out, Nanami might not be our sister. That's what I've, figured out right now. But instead, someone who's supposed to protect us from the people who have imagined us? Question mark? I don't know. Let's go.
Where?
ナナちゃんをさらった誘拐犯のところ決着つけなくちゃいけないの。ナナちゃんのことも他のこともこのままだと拓も守りきれないし。そんなの無責任だ。僕にここまでひどいこと言っておいて逃げるの。
Wow, Takumi, you're such a bitch, dude. Remy moved away from me. One step, another step, little by little. One step, two step, Oh my god, that reminds me of that song by, what is that band called? The Doobie Brothers. One Step Closer. Alright, cue the video. I'm sure there is one. Now that was live in 1987, but there's even what I think to be a version with an even cooler saxophone solo by Cornelius Bumpus, which is like the fucking coolest name ever. And I'll link that in here as well because, well, deal with it. Alright, welcome back, guys. I see her one step closer. Nah. Alright, little by little, she widened the distance between us. Hey, I don't have a room. I don't fucking know, dude. What the fuck? A gentle tone of voice. After telling me such cruel things, why did she become kind again?
Demo, 一つだけ 約束. もう 妄想はしない. ね. タクの妄想力はとっても強いから. 妄想すればするほど 本物のあなたの命が削られていっちゃうんだ.
何よ?
それじゃ また明日. 石.
Remy snapped off a salute. She had on an incredibly out of place smile. But soon, tears quietly overflowed from her eyes. Turning her back to me as though flustered, Rimi ran off with shaking shoulders. Once I'd watched her go in a trance, I crumpled in place. You know, if you search deep inside, you should know it's probably Shogun, right? The world looked drained of its colors. I couldn't detect any hope. She'd completely denied my existence itself. There wasn't any meaning in my being here. There wouldn't even be any meaning in my dying. Rimi had left, leaving behind this meaningless me. She too was my enemy. She deceived me. I see through the lies of the Jedi. And after telling me everything like that, she must have lost her reason for being with me. Rimi had cast me aside, because apparently I was delusionary existence, because I was a monster. Alright, how much dollar for till Shogun shows up? I didn't care anymore. I didn't care about anything anymore. Lacking the energy to stand up, unable to sort out my emotions, too shocked to weep. The breeze that came just before twilight stole the heat from the very core of my body. The faint remnants of Rimi's warmth disappeared as well. When I took an aimless look up at the sky, most of the sunset had already been invaded by the darkness of night. Fuck, dude.
Shit's fucked.
Momose smiled and scrutinized the Gero Froggy key holder Bun had bought for her. Bun looked at you as though seeking salvation.
Namidame Gero Kairun
desu. Namidame. Alright. This music is fucking chill as fuck, dude! I love it! Persona 5 has the same kind of chill as fuck music that really fits these types of games. In fact, in most of the Japanese stores, if you go in there, they have like this kind of music playing. It's really fucking weird. Music, dude. I love it. I love that music. It's fucking amazing, dude. Wow. Oh my god. Sorry. Taking a slurp of my drink. But Momose, rather than lend an ear to Bun's joking objection, poured some tea for Yua. How coincidental, I'm drinking tea as well. With forest fruits. This Let's Play is sponsored by Lipton Iced Tea. I mean, what? Despite her positions as Yua's elder and the company president. Sighing, Bun took a seat and looked around the office. Today, unusually, the Frisia employees who always stayed here until late at night as they worked appeared for once to have gone home at a more regular time. So it was written on the whiteboard that contained each employee's plans for the day. Thanks to that, although the sun had just set, the office interior was dead quiet in the middle of the night. In the middle of the night reminds me of that song by Whitesnake. I'm not gonna put that clip in here. Before they boarded the train at Harajuku, Bun made a call to Momose and asked her to see what she could find out about Shinko. still wearing an ear-to-ear smile, Momose flicked a look at Yua, who was tilting her tea, tilting back her teacup.
Yua-chan, ocha wo nondara kaeta hou ga ii wa.
She's telling you to get the fuck out of here.
Ki mo kureta shi. Go ryoushin ga shinpai suru de shou?
The real question is, do the Knights of Gladiol have parents? We only know Senna has parents, I think. Yua realized that Momus's demeanor concealed an ulterior motive. What they were about to discuss wasn't fit for her, a regular to civilian, to simply listen to offhand.
So, Johnny.
Turning serious, Momose nodded. Though Yua was grateful for her thoughtfulness, she shook her head firmly. I agree. Yua's words held an unyielding and dignified strength. Taken aback by her unexpected rebellion, Momose grew perplexed. Ganko. Oh, this is true. She is an accomplice at this point, so whatever, right? Bun's carefree attitude had the opposite effect of leaving Momose unable to hold in a deep sigh. Giving Bun a polite brush off, Momose closely studied Yua's face.
Fucking
hell. I keep right-clicking out of reflex. I don't know why. I'm not playing a shooter. Her expression strained. Yua nodded. Upon seeing that and taking one more sigh, Momose sat down in her chair. Her plump body grew rounder still, and she began moving the mouse connected to her laptop. Bun and Yua peeked at the monitor from behind Momose. Like, what the fuck, dude? she's like, what the fuck? Nozomi Group.
Hey, let me
fucking read this for you. This is fucking great. A wildly popular item, Gero Froggy. Everyone knows about a certain ultra creepy super popular character mascot, right? These are the famous Gero Froggy goods. Their uniquely weird oddball face are what set them apart. Add yourself to the ranks of those surprised by their vivid and detailed expressions. What the fuck is that, man? The weekend. I can't wait for the weekend to begin. No, I'm not doing it. I'm not pasting that shit in here, okay? Everyone's working for the weekend. Alright, fuck it. Fuck it. Do it. Welcome back. God damn it. Bun showed a keen reaction to that keyword. That's right, the GE rates always went up during the weekend. Not that you would remember, since it's been fucking 3 or 4 years since we last talked about GE rate.
Oh. 前に見せた GE レートのグラフ覚えてる ?5 年ぐらい前からずっと毎週末に値が上がってるって言ったわよね。新興が望みグループに合併された時期とぴったり一致するわ。
What the fuck was that? Dappei? Maybe? I mean, my Japanese is pretty good, but I don't know all the words. Dappei. I guess that means take over?
新興がレートを操作してると思うか
進行自体はそんなに大きな会社じゃないから、それは無理よ。
どなたと親会社、望みが怪しい。グループ総出で取り組めば、レート操作だってできそうじゃねえか。
待って、望みの方はもちろんだけど、進行が興味深いのはそこだけじゃないの。設立当初の資料にまで遡ってみたら、すごい大物が出てきたのよ。
大物？
井ノ原浩三。
Is that the blonde guy?
はは、明和党の重鎮じゃねえの。
新興設立当時はまだ民事党在籍時代だけどね。
つながってきたな。太田教授の。それとこの前の地震の時、明和党は G レートに関係ありそうな件について報道規制の圧力をかけてみて。
Hold on. Yes, we want BG.But we also want voice playback. Alright, there we go. Takashi Fumio. Norose Genichi. Okay.
G rate の graph のことだけど、いろいろ調べてたら、他にも面白いパターンを見つけたわ。
There were currently two aspects of the GE rate over the past 5 years to which Momose was paying attention. The periodic spikes that occurred every weekend. The highest values to emerge from this weren't especially notable, but it rose without fail every time, except on New Year's Eve and at the Bon Festival. The second part she looked at was the radical ascents that took place when earthquakes happened.During the earthquakes from 2 months ago, with 8 fatalities, and also the earthquake about a week ago, in which over 100 died, the GE rate had temporarily skyrocketed.
で、3つ目のパターン。
3つ目のパターン。
この5年で4回だけ起きてるわ。時期はどれもまちまち。上昇値は地震の時ほどじゃないけど、結構高いの。最初はこれが何を意味しているのかわからなかったんだけど、調べていくうちにこの5年で4回と符合するイベントに行き着いた。
イベント？
もったいぶらずに欲しいのよ。
選挙よ。
おお。
衆参合わせて4度行われた選挙日と その4回の G 入れと上昇の日は完全に同じだったわ。
It's fucking Illuminati shit, bro. His face grim. Bun rubbed the 5 o'clock shadow on his chin.
野党だった明和党が大躍進を遂げて与党になった選挙は
4年前ですね。
そして井ノ原公造が民事党を電撃的に離党して明和党に移ったのは5年前。
Oh. An oppressive silence abruptly hovered between the three of them.
なんだか私、お話を聞いていたら怖くなってきました。
Yeah, well, you fucked yourself. They told you to fuck off. You murmured, her voice trembling mutely.
私もびっくりだわ。ここまでキーワードがぴったり当てはまるなんてね。
I would doubt for my life in this situation.
まだ状況証拠でしかないかな。
It is true.
でも G レートのことを知っていたからこそ気づけたわけだ。知らなかったらさっぱりだったろ。
Said Bun, taking his usual fan in hand and casually starting to fan himself.
ところで、俺が調べた女子高生の生態について話していいかい？
Mama drew a sharp look at Ben, exasperated by his sudden attempt to change the subject.
あのね、いきなりそんなくだらないこと言い出すんじゃないわよ。ユアちゃんがいるんだから少しは考えなさい。
ね、そういうなって。
A grin floated up to Bun's face, but there was no smile in his eyes, again.
青いセナについてだ。え？正しくは、ハタのセナと言うべきか。なぜか最近になって、母親の旧姓を使い始めたんだな。そのハタのセナの父親、ハタの一世は今失踪して行方不明らしいんだが、のぞみテクノロジーの元社員なんだよ。
What the fuck, man? That's I mean, we knew this, but
どういうこと？
どういうことも何もそのまんまさ。
The Nozomi Technology Company was an enterprise primarily involved in developing software for medical equipment. The Nozomi Group had started as a Nozomi Technology Company, becoming one of the biggest conglomerates in Japan after several mergers and acquisitions.
半年前、畑野瀬名の母親と生後1年の妹が謎の死を遂げている。父親の失踪はその直後だ。畑野瀬名本人もそれと前後して当時預けられていたとある施設を脱走するって騒ぎを起こした。
施設ですか？
天神寮っていう非営利の自立更生支援施設だ。表向きはな。
表向きってじゃあ裏があるの？
スポンサーがいるのさ。これが天聖振興会だったりする。
天聖振興会。
モモセグリムス。 She let out a voice of blatant disgust.
また面倒な名前が出てきたわね。
ちなみにその天神寮は2年前まで別の名前だった。アークハートメディカル会。
おお。From what I remember, if we filled in the papers back like way back in like episode 12 or 14 or 15, that said ARK at the top.
どんな偶然か、今や渋谷の若者のカリスマ的存在であるフェス。岸本綾瀬もここに入れられていたんだな。畑野瀬名とは入れ違いだったみてえだが。
At this point, Bun leaned towards Momose.
でだ。ここからが興味深いんだが。アークハートメディカル会は、T 天神寮と違ってメンタルケア施設だった。精神病患者を治療してたんだ。
精神病患者。Okay. The more we learn in Japanese, the better. Was it 精神病患者？
パークハートメディカル会は天神寮と違ってメンタルケア施設だった。精神病患者を治療してたんだ。
はい。
ところが2年前、アークハートメディカル会は突然非営利団体の自立更生支援施設天神寮へと姿を変えた。それによって精神科医が一斉に解雇されたんだが、その医師たちを丸ごと雇い入れたのが代々木にある AH 東京総合病院だった。
All right.
ノータリン事件で殺された人が勤めていたのってそこの病院でしたよね。
ああ、高階文夫。確かに AH 東京総合病院の精神科医だ。ついでに言うと、そこの病院長は井ノ花と懇意らしいぜ。
また井ノ花議員ね。
ゆあちゃん、君が追ってた西条匠も実は AH 東京総合病院をこの1ヶ月で3回訪れてる。
そうなんですか。
警察がずっと尾行してたんだね。確かだ。しかも西条には数年前にその病院に入院した記録まであった。彼の主治医は高階文夫だ。
We all remember Takashina Fumio.
不思議なのは西条の入院記録なんだな。彼は10歳で入院して約2年後にその記録が途切れてるんだが、退院した記録はなかった。
Alright. So, the... Looks like the guy who...Shogun is, you would think he's like an old man, but he has that disease where you age faster. Progeria, I think is what it's called, which is why he looks like an old man.
誰かが改ざんしたのかしら。
どうだかな。そこまでは調べが回らなくてね。まあ、それと畑野瀬名に関してもう一つ。最近彼女がよく行動を共にしている折原梢って生徒がいる。1ヶ月ほど前に転校してきた西条のクラスメートなんだが、この子も結構ないわくつきなんだ。折原の父親がのぞみグループの系列会社社員なわけよ。元は広島の方に住んでてな、折原梢の同級生3人が何者かに襲われて重傷を負うって事件が起きてる。3人ともが右腕を鋭利な刃物で切断されて、ひどいありさまだったらしい。
シャッボイ。
折原もその場に居合わせていた。彼女が犯人じゃねえかって疑いがかかったんだが、凶器が存在しないって理由で逮捕はされてない。それで地元に居づらくなって引っ越したって噂もある。
凶器が存在しない？見つからないじゃなくて？
ああ、存在しないだ。何で切られたのかさえ分かってない。犯行は折原以外には実行できない状況だった。だが、たとえ折原が犯人だとしても、凶器をどこからか取り出すことも、どこかに隠すことも不可能だった。かまいたち現象じゃないかなんて。本気で議論されたぐらいだ。
かまいたち。
何もないところから剣を取り出す手品
かもしれねえな。
君が悪いです。
You are shrank into herself, rubbing her upper arms in an attempt to stop her trembling.
何かとても大きな意志が働いているような。
職業柄俺は陰謀論なんざ信じちゃいねえんだが、今回ばかりはその存在を信じそうになるね。 明和党、そしてのぞみグループ。G レートに関係してると思われるのはその2つか。
天聖振興会も叩けば埃が出てきそうね。もともとあまりいい噂は聞かないし。
Mumusei took a sip of her tea and shrugged.
本来の仕事をほったらかしにして、こんなことを調べてたなんて、バンちゃんには呆れるわ。
元はといえば、ももちゃんが G レートのことを教えてくれたのがいけないのだ。
そうだけど、それで捜査本部から外されちゃったら世話ないわ。本当に不器用なんだから、あんたって人は。
So she's Though she spoke exasperately, she wasn't condemning him, and her words were in fact a backhand compliment for Ban as a detective. Maybe it's Sua, who I still don't trust. Ban's ringtone was playing. When he looked at the LCD screen, the caller was unknown. Oh god. Ah, it's one of those fucked up calls.He heard a violent noise through the receiver. He took the phone away from his ear and looked at the screen, but it looked like he had good reception. The problem was on the caller's side. Ban cocked his head, wondering if maybe there was some place far away from any cell towers. It was one of the unidentified threatening calls Ban had often received as of late.The mechanical sounding voice probably came from a voice changer. Ban smiled bitterly as he answered.
Oh, anta ka. Ii kagen nanotte kunnai ka na. Te o hike tte iwarete mo na. Somosomo nani kara te o hikya ii n da? Soko o gutaiteki ni itte moraneu to.
The calls always cut off there. He'd say back out twice and then end it. The pattern was so consistent, one could pretty much call it a certainty. No matter how much Ban called out, no answer would come to him. Yet today was different. Oh shit, Sua.
Darada.
Having heard that much, Ban finally grasped who was the owner of the anguished voice coming on the other side of the phone belonged to.
Suaka. Dara ni yarata? Ima doko ni iru?
No matter how much Bun cried out to him, nothing came back through the phone anymore. Clicking his tongue, he pressed the end button.Momosei and Yua watched him anxiously. Standing up, Ban hit himself lightly on the cheek two times. It has to be that nurse, right? The fucked up nurse that was talking to herself. Ugh! Getting the creeps just thinking about her. Probably.
じゃあまずい気がする。
応援を頼んだ方がいいわ。
大事にしたらそれこそ諏訪の命はねえよ。俺一人で様子を見てくる。
いやー、それはちょっと。Ban left his favorite fan atop the desk, within Momosei's reach. Then he looked at each of the two women in turn. The ever unreliable middle-aged detective had a look of fearless determination.One that made him seem a different person.
Momo-chan and Yua-chan, どこかに身を隠せ。わかったな。
Shit, boy. Wow. All right, well, whatever. We're going to save it here. I'm going to take a shower because I just shat myself. And we'll see each other back in a few, where we'll continue with this amazing, amazing story. Great, great, great. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Thank you.